reason we come to church is simply to adore God, to worship Him, to venerate our Virgin Mother Mary. And that takes, well, first of all, time and much love. That's why we are here. That's basically the first reason for us to be, because there is so much that we need to adore and acknowledge from what God has created. A theologian from the 1950s, when colored television came into use, he said that the Blessed Virgin Mary is the gospel in technicolor. Why? Well, simply because what we need is to love God, to adore Him, to unite ourselves with Him. That's what the heart desires more than anything else in this world. But today we would say that the Blessed Virgin Mary is the gospel in HD, in high definition. Because that's what it is. See? There is nothing in this world that we desire the most than to be able to unite ourselves, or to unite our souls with God. That's basically the only thing we need. And our Blessed Virgin Mother was the first one to fulfill the first commandment and the second, like the first one, to love God above everything else and to love our neighbor as ourselves. The gospel for today is just the beginning of the Annunciation. And the gospel says, the angel appears to her and he says, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with thee." She was the only person capable of being called like that. Full of grace, the Lord is with you. And there is only one thing that she is being asked for, her to become the mother of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And if you remember, she had consecrated her virginity to God from the time of her childhood. And the angel says to her, "Well, you are going to conceive a son." And she says, "How can this be? How can I give to God, how can I give to men what I have given to God from the time I was a little creature?" See? Then the angel explains everything to her, and she says, "Well, let it be done according to your word." If the Blessed Virgin Mary could have written an autobiography of herself, she would have to say simply, "Let it be done according to your word." Because that's the first difference between us and our Mother Mary, that she had no will for herself. Everything had to be done according to the will of God. See? So she basically gave a blank check of her life to God. "Do with me as you say." Which is so different for us, because we think, the majority of the cases, we think that our plans are better than God's plans. So At the end of her life, we see her by the foot of the cross. Then a few moments later, we see her embracing the body, the lifeless body of her son. And the thing is that she had to be there because she was the only one capable of being there. She knew that those wounds in the body of our Lord had not been caused by her sins, because she was sinning. So only her could have been there. So today, we thank God for this beautiful image of our Blessed Mother. Her life, her union with God, her humility, her obedience to God. So with her, we understand that in order for us to be united with God, which is the only thing that we desire the most, two things have to take place. The first one is that there must be nothing in the soul which is contrary to the divine will. And secondly, that the human will be moved in everything only by the will of God. And that already accomplishes union with God. And that's what happened to her. See? So today, if we contemplate the image of our Mother Mary, we see that she has one foot upon the earth. This teaches us that if we wish to retain our innocence, we must sever our hearts from all inordinate desire from those things of this world. Secondly, she has another foot on the snake, on temptation, on Satan. Then we see her in pious meditation. If we want to persevere in union with God, we need to do this, to have a clear understanding of those evils that surround us upon the earth. And secondly, have a clear understanding of who is our enemy, where he is. And thirdly, that we remain in prayer, regardless of what we do every day. So this poor creature, our Mother Mary, in her simple life, in her simplicity, in her humility, she knew that God was interested in what she was going to do every single day of her life. That's all she needed to know. That's why she did everything in her power to live united to the will of God. So may the invocation of the Immaculate Mary obtain for us grace that by the practice of virtue our lives may be conformable to hers, and that we in this world of sin may always walk pure and spotless in the presence